Hello everyone, welcome back to Grand Project Cars. So as promised, today we are going to do the test scan on the Nissan J31. Let's start the OBD port of the vehicle, which is usually located under the steering wheel. You can find it pretty easily. So this is the OBD cable, and let's go and fix it. And you should make sure the device is on. It is. And to find the port, in this case it's over here. You can see the white color input. Okay. You hear the beep, and it immediately starts to scan the VIN number. We need to make sure the ignition is on. So I'm gonna reduce. Let's go back. On the ignition. There you go. And let's hop in. So the vehicle is connected, make sure the cables are connected and the ignition is on, and let's start the process. So let's go on to diagnosis and select Nissan. Okay. Okay, so we are going to... The auto search function actually didn't work in this vehicle. It works on some and does not. So first we are going to do a full system diagnosis. It's a 16 pin. And we are going to take a system scan. I hope you can see it. Okay, so it went through all the systems, but only these four are equipped in this particular vehicle. So we are going to go into the engine control module and see if there's any problem. So we're going to read fault codes. Read data stream. So we have here the, as I told you guys in the last video, if anything is not working properly, it's basically going to show you in red. So here currently we don't have anything in red, so everything is working well. Let's go to the page 2. Vehicle speed. air condition off. Shall we on and see what happens? We can also record data like that and then save. So diagnosis again, it's Nissan, was it? Full system, 16 pin. Let's go to health report. So it's telling the not equipped systems as well. You can see electronic power steering does not have it. It has a hydraulic system. Okay, so everything is normal. It says the engine control module is normal. Anti-lock braking system is normal. SRS is normal. Transmission control is normal. Can enter each one, I guess. Read data stream. Coolant temperature, cooling fan. Cooling fan's off. Temperature is Fahrenheit. So you can change this temperature metrics by going on to settings to Celsius as well. You can clear codes, but unfortunately I do not have codes. I think fortunately I do not have codes. It's a data stream in this one. Let's see what we have. Battery voltage. Can clear codes when there are nothing. Just showing you how to do it. Transmission, there was one code earlier when I tested, was, you know, because the transmission was replaced. No, it's no problem. Read data stream. Yeah, it's in the first one, it's in the park, okay. Okay, so our report, we can make a report like this one. So it'll show if there was any error. This case I don't. You can share it via an email, okay. Diagnostic report for Nissan, you can just send it to your own email, or maybe if it's a customer's email, you can send it to the customer's email. So you'll get a report. And let's go back. System selection, so you can select systems as well. E-powertrain is something this does not have. Let's go to steering, if not electronic power steering, it's nothing. SRS. We're scanning the SRS system, so it's equipped. What is this error? Okay, so it's showing some sort of a airbag problem. Faulty driver airbag, faulty spiral cable. Driver airbag harness is open. Driver airbag circuit, poor electrical connection. Something to look at. So you need to report it actually. Right, so that is important. Share that with yourself. I need to check on that later. So I wonder why it didn't show me in the health report. So I think it's normal now or something. I need to check on that. Read fault codes. So currently there are no fault codes. Trouble. Diag record. Maybe there's some sort of problem. It's not equipped. Transmission. Engine active engine mount, so this vehicle is equipped with that. Oh, no, it was equipped. So I'll put a feedback later. Engine control module. traction control system. Okay, fine. System selection, so we did all three. Let's go back. What does Nissan GTR means? Put here vehicle, okay, whatever. So you got IM readiness, what will it do? Failed. Battery voltage. Resets, so these are the resets you can do, electronic throttle relay and oil reset, brake reset, and all the other things. Protocols. You can go to data, you can see the diagnostic reports, and that's it actually, there's nothing else to show you guys. So I did all the upgrades last night, zero upgradable software, so everything's upgraded. So now the vehicle is actually started, you can see, right, it is started, and we're going to see the live data. Full system diagnosis, 16 pin. This takes some time, but let's bear with me. So you can scan electronic power steering, then pre-crash seatbelts, shift, hybrid system, what else? Brake, active engine mount, traction control, airbag 2, okay, whatever. Engine control module, we're gonna go there. So, we are going to read data stream, there are no fault codes, right, we're going to go data stream, and main signals, so we have the accelerator sensor, air condition is now on, Okay, so the before battery voltage, brake switch is off, and I'm gonna press the brake pedal, just press now, and it should turn on. Yeah, it's turning on. I'm gonna leave it, and it should turn off, and it does. So coolant temperature is 192.2. engine speed is currently running at 913 rpm, which I'm gonna give a small rev. Let's see what happens. Okay, it's catching up. You can see it's on 2000 rpm, 2100. So accordingly, we can see the oxygen sensors as well, auto sensors, ignition timing. So as I told you guys earlier, if anything is not right, it will definitely show us that particular parameter in red. So currently everything is doing okay. Mass airflow, you can see here. Throttle sensor, vehicle speed is zero, we're not traveling anywhere. Okay, let's go back. Let's lower the AC, it's cold. Let's go to the anti-lock braking system. Let's read data here. Circuit relay is on, ABS warning lamp is off. It's again showing you the battery voltage. Right, so the airbag system, let's see, now it's all should be working. Read data stream. Status invalid, yes, there's no much of a data to read. Read focus, there's nothing. Trouble diag record is there, which is this one, right? We checked earlier. Transmission control module. Module or module, whatever. Read data. Main signal. So engine RPM is 960, 800, okay. Gear is 1. Let's turn to, I think you can see D and see what happens. Still gear is 1 and RPM dropped to 800. Let's put it to 3 and see. Sorry, I cannot see this thing. Gear is still at 1. Afraid by it is still at 1. Select a lever position. Okay, this is changing, so let's put a 3. Yeah, actually on 3, not D. This is D and this is 3. 2 it's taking in, 1 it's taking in, neutral it's taking in, R it's taking in, and P. Okay, throttle position. So when you accelerate, it actually increase. Vehicle speed is off, PS is 0. You can see the engine RPM graph here since the startup. So actually gearbox repair was done and everything seems to be working fine. So right? So that's it for the scanning. Again, let's get a health report to make sure everything is okay. So everything is normal. Can have that report. Okay, and that's it. So I am readiness. I am not sure why it is failing. I need to research personally on that. If you guys have any idea, please drop in the comment section below. Battery voltage, again, we've been looking at it since all day now. Reset functions, okay, so the auto reset is pretty important if you have European vehicle. Right, so the throttle relay, and I actually did it manually, you know, without a OBD to this particular vehicle. Sometime back around few months back. So that's it. So I'll stop this video here so you can go into metrics so you can see everything in Celsius and all. Right, that's it guys, and another important feature of this scanner tool is it charges while it's plugged into your vehicle, so which is a good thing in case you're running out of battery. It will This is what convenient to have it that way, and it is very solidly built. If you drop it, there is a very minimal chance to break this thing down. And so that's it guys, so that's